few weeks ago, we told you nearly 700,000 people will lose access to the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, commonly known as SNAP or food stamps. In December, the Trump administration finalized a rule limiting benefits for able-bodied adults between the ages of 18 and 49 who don't have dependents and who are unemployed or working less than 20 hours a week. Under a federal law dating back to the Clinton administration, they only qualified for 3 months of benefits in a three-year period. But historically, states have had the power to waive those requirements in areas with high unemployment rates and few jobs. The new rule makes it harder for states to do that. We spent a day with Ronald MacIntyre, a young man who's looking for work and who's in jeopardy of losing his benefits.
My name is Ronald MacIntyre. I live here in Washington, D.C., and I receive SNAP benefits. I receive $200 in SNAP benefits each month. I've been receiving benefits for about 5 years. Right now, I live with my grandmother and my grandfather. This is like our primary means of food support. When I'm shopping, conscious about when it comes to comparing prices and not just throw things in the cart and or just get the most expensive thing when it really is no different. It can be a bit much mentally sometimes if something was to not add up right with my card and my benefits, that this would affect a few other people, you know, this would affect my entire family, not just me. It's definitely like some weight on my shoulders. My benefits are even more important to me because I'm trying to further and advance myself for my family. My experience with Bite Back has been wonderful. Bite Back is, first of all, it's free IT training. There's stipulations you have to meet. One of them being you have to be a SNAP recipient. If I wasn't a SNAP recipient, I wouldn't be able to be a part of Bite Back. And Bite Back is providing me the skills, the IT skills, the tech skills I need to seek living wage employment. These are the type of steps I'm taking to where as though I won't be on SNAP.
My name is Melissa Stallings. I'm the Chief Program Officer here at Bite Back. We've actually received SNAP funding through the DC Department of Human Services now for 5 years, and it really has helped to provide opportunities to individuals who are seeking to either obtain employment or who are underemployed. By cutting funding of SNAP benefits to our students, it really does greatly reduce their opportunity to obtain access to training opportunities like Bite Back. It also impacts us as an organization, the ability to be able to find sustainable funding, but it does impact our students in a large way.
I'm a new father. My daughter, her name is Mesa. She's 4 months. She's a doll, my ball of joy. It's weird, like, caring about somebody and thinking about somebody so much all the time. It's like such a new thing for me. I really, really want to find a career in the IT area. These jobs pay really well, and with these type of wages, these are wages you can really support your family on. Obviously, at that point, I won't need SNAP benefits. I just want to support my family and make decent money.
What's up, class?
So, it's just hopefully happily ever after.
Class ends on February 13th, but Bite Back will continue to offer free tutoring and training until he's certified in his field and hired. The new SNAP rule goes into effect in April.